Hello friends, myself Professor Lau Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, Automobile Engineering Department. So we are in continuing with subject vehicle dynamics, and we are talking about chapter aerodynamics. So in previous lecture we have seen about the vehicle dynamics, like what do you mean by vehicle dynamics, how the vehicle dynamics are going to affect my overall vehicle performance while it is in moving condition. Also we have seen about the several axis systems like SAE axis system, earth fixed coordinate system, etc. So based on these, today we are going to move about the dynamic axle load and equation of motion. So these are the main two topics in GTU also. So it is very most important topic at the exam point of view. So let us begin with the dynamic axle loads. Like what do you mean by dynamic axle loads? And there are several equations, like there are three equations that we have taken into our consideration while talking about the analysis of dynamic axle load. So let us begin with the theory, that what do you mean by dynamic axle loads. Then first we can say that the important step to consider as an analysis, we have to make sure that acceleration and braking performance, like if my vehicle is in such acceleration or in braking condition. So in these kind of maneuvers, what we will feel, we will find load transfer as well as the weight transfer, or we can say that the load is moving while accelerating and braking different condition. Also, because the axle loads that determine the tractive effort obtained at each axle. So we are considering two axle, front axle and rear axle. So while accelerating and braking, such loads are going to transfer either in front axle or in rear axle, if we are talking about the traction effort also. So here significant forces that are shown in figure. So first let us consider one example of a car that is in dynamic condition or at a certain angle theta. So here you can see that the grade, that is theta angle, that is there at which the vehicle is moving. First load, that is DA. Here you can see that DA, that is the aerodynamic drag at which comes from frontal side, and that is due to the air. And let us assume that the height of that DA, that is HS, that is height for aerodynamic forces. If we are talking about the tires, here you can see that the two tires, A, that is the rear wheel, and B, that is the front wheel. So at these two points you will find WR and WF. So that are the forces, or we can say that the opposite forces acting on my wheel at a perpendicular direction. So WR is for rear wheel and WF, that is for my front wheel. And here you can see that FXF and FXR. So FXF and FXR, that are the tracting forces. So FXF is for the front and FXR is for the rear. So these two are the tracting forces. To oppose that we have RXF and RXR. So that is due to the friction between the road and the tire. So these two forces that we are going to consider, like RXF and RXR. So these are for the opposite direction of FXF and FXR. Here wheel base is capital L, center of gravity or point, we can see that at which downward force W is acting. The two forces that we are considering, W cos theta and W sin theta. Also we have considered D'Alembert's rule acceleration formula, that is W by G into AX. Here you can see that AX, that is the acceleration of the vehicle. Also at rear side you will find RHX, RHZ force, that are the point at which the vehicle is going to tow at that particular point, and HH, that is the distance. So overall this figure is most important to consider any kind of dynamic axle load analysis. So let us begin with the data. Here you can see that capital W, that is the overall weight of the vehicle. Cos and sin, these are the components for grade conditions. Like as I said, due to acceleration, the D'Alembert force that is applied, that is W by G into AX, WF and WR, that are the dynamic weights for the front wheel and rear wheel. also tapping force FXF and FXR is there, rolling resistance RXF and RXR is there. Due to that, contact pitch DA, that is the aerodynamic force, HA, where the aerodynamic force that is going to happen, RHZ and RHX, that are the vertical and longitudinal forces acting at hinge point or towing point. Let us talk about the theory. Here we are considering the load on the front axle can be found by summing torques about the point A under the rear tires. So we are talking about the point A, that is my rear wheel tires. So we are considering that point A. Also presuming that the vehicle is not accelerating and the sum of the torque at point A must be zero. So let us consider the figure and talk about point A. And we are talking about the clockwise torque. So let us calculate. So here with reference to point A, we will find the WF, that is the force, into capital L, that is distance, that is WF into L plus DA into HA. So these are the sum of the overall forces that acting with reference to point A. So again, DA into HA plus W by G into AX into H plus RHX into HH plus RHZ into DH plus WH sin theta minus WC cos theta, that is equal to zero. Now moving further, we can see that for uphill at altitude, you can see that the theta angle, that is positive, while the downhill we are taking as a or considering as a negative. Now solving with reference to WF, what we will get? We will get the WF term, that is simple solution from the above equation. And likewise, we are considering the point B, or we can say the front wheel. So from that we will get WR value. So these are the final equations of WF and WR. These are the dynamic force on the rear wheel and front wheel. So from these equations, we will able to solve several equations. So this is all about the dynamic axle loading. Now let us consider about the equation of motion. So first case, that is the static load on level ground. So if I am talking about level ground, that means the theta angle, that is the zero. So we are considering sine term, that is zero, and cosine term is one. Also we can say that RHX, RHZ, acceleration is zero. So due to that, aerodynamic drag, that is zero. So by putting this value on above equation or the previous equation, we will find WF, that is for S for static loads, WC by capital L, also for the rear wheels like WRS is equal to W into B by L. So this is first equation that shows us the static load on level ground. If we are talking about low speed acceleration, so for that we are considering or presuming that aerodynamic force, that is going to zero. Also the ground level is, also the level is in ground, or we can say that the again sine theta term is zero and cosine term is one. So after solving the above equation or previous equation, we will find WF, that is WFS minus WAX into H by G into L, also for the rear wheel as well, WRS plus W into AX into H by G into L. So this is the second equation of motion at which we are considering low speed acceleration for that particular vehicle. Now third and the final most equation, in which we can see that the load on a grade. So here we are considering theta angle. So grade is defined as the rise over run. So the we are considering the ratio, that is tangent of the grade angle theta. Also the several grade angles that are particular interstate highway or national highway we are considering. So basically we are considering in between 10 degree to 12 degree, or somewhat we have limited to 4% for interstate highway. So now what are going to happen? The cosine angle, that is very small, so we are taking as equal to 1. So cos theta, that is 1, and sine theta, that is theta, because it is very close to the angle itself. So finally we will get one equation, that is for WF and WR, that is the dynamic load on the front wheel and rear wheel. So WF, that is my WFS minus WF theta in by L, also for WR, that is W in RS plus W into H by L into theta. So by considering these dynamic load condition, we will find these three equation of motion. So this is very important topic exam point of view. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you.